So, first question. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for this presentation. Developments to our presentation in classroom must be accurate and precise way. If you feel that the materials are required, you must use, you must demand and elaborate in the classroom in a very wise manner. So, after that, we come to that, we have to explain the work of the heart, how heart pumps blood. We can make students understand with the help of 3D animation. It will be very useful. So, some kind of things are there which can be helpful by using some kind of materials. You can use some softwares, you can use 3D animations, you can use diagrams, chart paper, whatever kinds are there. So these are the important things to develop presentation and things. Association and comparison. It is always desirable that new ideas or knowledge be associated to daily life situations by citing suitable examples and by drawing comparisons with the related concepts. This is the same kind of things what is explained in Bloom's taxonomies. Relate the topic, the things with the objects. You can also say, if we are explaining a mathematical formula such as a plus b whole square, so let students be concerned that what are the importance of a plus b whole square. If you can't explain that, sir, what is the actual use? The student does not respond. Sir, what is the use of a plus b whole square plus minus So, we need to make him understand, associate the things with the life, where the use of a plus b whole square are there in our life. This thing we need to associate in our daily life. By doing such kind of things, we can develop the concept. And little things can also be done there. So, to establish principles, we need to do things properly. That's it. Generalizing. This concept is concerned with systemizing of the knowledge, learn, comparison, and contrast lead to generalization. And efforts should be made ensure that students draw the conclusion themselves. It should result in students' own thinking, reflection, and experiences. In the practices of a DL, it is also taught there that if you learn something, that must be shown in your behavior. If you learn something and not reflecting of your behavior, that means you are not grasping that thing. So, if you have obtained knowledge, the behavior must change. Now, so this is the thing, sir, that knowledge must acquire in the things related to the work or behavior of student. If your knowledge is not coming in the sense of behavior of student, that means we are not getting the things.
It is directly related to the knowledge.
Of course, sir. Because knowledge reflects within our behavior. So, behavior is the mirror by which we can estimate how much knowledge one is getting and how much is increasing. So, behavior proportional to knowledge. Application, understand your concepts, get your knowledge, showing behavior, but only showing behavior is not enough. You have to apply. If you have acquired many kind of degrees, and you also show that kind of degrees in your behavior, it is not enough. You should apply this degree in some kind of work. Means that must be maintained in some kind of work. So application requires a whole deal of mental activity to think and apply the skills learned in new situation. So knowledge, or you can say the mental these are the things by which we get the sense to apply our knowledge in our daily life. Encapsulation means whatever we have learned all together, we just summarize it and get the extract what we have learned. So the last step for this class, the teacher class myself, whether the students have understood or grasped the subject matter or not. This is used for assessing evaluating the effectiveness of the lesson by asking students questions on the content of the lesson or by the sort of self-evaluation to answer in this level. So, encapsulation means gathering all the information together what we have gained in our academic life. So, in this things, the knowledge, behavior, information, facts, all the things comes all together and use that things in a proper way in our life or in our career to make it so. So sir was asking on that time, the lesson plan is important for not actually you need to clarify here that lesson plan and week plan both are different. Lesson plan is on the short span, but week plan has span for a long span, means a week or a month. So the basic difference of lesson plan and week plan is there. So whatever we are writing in the lesson plan template, that is actually the unit plan. Lesson plan is written separately for separate periods. So unit plan follow much the same format. Lesson plan cover an entire unit of work which may span several days or weeks. Modern constructive thinking styles may not require individual lesson plan. The unit plan may include specific objectives, timelines, but lesson plan can be more fluid as they adapt to student needs and learning style. One more information here. Lesson plan is framed according to demands of student's choice, but unit plan is framed according to our demands. In what time we have to finish the topic, I know. And according to that, we would frame the unit plan. But lesson plan should be framed according to the demands of students. What topic must be there? What kind of students are there? What is the learning speed, capacity? All the things impact by framing lesson plan. So lesson plan and unit plan both are different and similar. So
sir, can you give some example?
The first yes. For all lesson plan.
Lesson plan and unit plan.
So nowadays, what we are writing on our templates of lesson plan, that is actually a unit plan. Because we framed it for a week, not for a separate period. Lesson plan is made for separate period. So whatever we are writing in the templates of that lesson book, that is the unit plan, not the lesson plan. And there are a time boundary that within this timeline we have to finish this book. So time requirement is essential part of unit plan. So more detailed explanation is here, criteria of a rookie class. Needs, capabilities, interest, sound psychological knowledge, learning experience, sustained attention, physical environment, development of learners, personality. How would you frame the rookie class? These are the things. First of all, needs, capabilities, interest. No use class needs what actually student demands. Means what is the level of student. If you are entering the class and giving more and more lectures at your level, the class is not being so good. So first of all, know your students. KYS. So needs, capabilities, and interest of the learner must be considered before giving lectures in the classroom. If you don't know the classroom, you don't have the sense what we are actually giving, what the actual students are getting from our side. Number two, sound psychological knowledge. Some sense of humor must be there in our classroom. We are teaching in classroom with a lot of seriousness. This should not happen. Some sense of humor must be there. Sense of humor reduces the tense phase of our mind. This is an important kind of things we must consider. Provides a new learning experience. Systematic but flexible. If two teachers teach same topic, difference must be there. So, how much effort you put there and what new kind of learning experience you are giving? This is the very important thing. So, topic must be delivered in a new learning experience. Because it can be happen that student might face same topic somewhere else. And that similar topic we are going to discuss. So some different experiences we have to create in the classroom. Sustain the attention of the learner till the end. It focuses on eye contact. From beginning to the end. Eye contact is very important. Eye contact could manage to classroom, the indiscipline. So this kind of things we need to consider that attention of the learner in the end we have to sustain. So this is the important topic in the shape of the classroom management also. Now next step. Related to social and physical environment of the learner. So what sort of social side the students coming? What's the origin of social? Means in what kind of nature is developing their senses? It is also necessary to consider. Social and physical environment of the learner also impact the learning capacity or learning progress of individual one. Last one, development of learner's personality. This behavior change. If personality is being modified or being changed, that means we are going in a good direction, whatever we are teaching is in a good way. So, next sir. Delivery of lesson. It is a big challenge. That means, in a mental way, you can think that this topic should be completed by today itself. And if we could not do on that time, so it would be improper. Delivery of lesson plan must be systematic, summarized, and time oriented. These are the things by which you can deliver lesson plan properly. So So at the start of teaching, to provide the student an overall picture of the material to be presented. Here key words is the kind. Principal ma'am always say that right keywords. So keywords analyze all the things, whatever is going to be happen, means what kind of things is going to be delivered in the classroom. Is mentioned here that kind of keywords. So students are focused there that teachers will explain this kind of topic or terms. So keywords binds all the things related to this topic. So keywords is an essential part of lesson plan. Organize the material so that it is presented in a logical manner and in meaningful units. Try to use terms and concepts that are already familiar to the students. Of course, we need to use the terms and concepts that are already familiar to the students. So, example must be like that the students are familiar. So, taking that kind of example, concept, facts would elaborate the skills of the students. Now, next one. Lesson plan and classroom management. Of course, lesson plan. So, lesson plan includes such kind of things. I have already stated here that eye contact, classroom management, proper delivery. So, these are the things by which classroom can be managed. So, lesson plan is very important. Or they also say it is the constitution of a class. By which law, by which rules the class would go, would decide it. So, frame that lesson plan according to yourself. Teachers can encourage critical thinking in a group setting by creating plans that include the student participating collectively. One word is here, critical thinking. Anybody can say what is critical thinking? What is critical thinking?
So means
the answer which normally may come, some different questions will arise there. Means a normal student, what kind of questions will arise. But in critical thinking, the student can ask some different kind of things. Suppose Newton asked why my apple is falling down. This was the critical thinking because no one is thinking that kind of things on that day. So critical thinking means the thinking beyond our imagination. That is called critical thinking. So critical thinking and creative work both are related. The students having critical thinking would have more creative in their classroom. So teachers and parents. Next, assignments. It is of many kinds of errors. Assignment means we are giving some special kind of homework to the students and they fulfill it. So assignments are either in class or shape form tasks to be completed for the next class period. These tasks are important because they help ensure that the instruction provides the students with the goal, the power to get there, and the interest to be engaged in rigorous academic context that require content and skills necessary to have participate in the coursework. Assignment is a kind of small responsibility given to the student. What is the coursework? It is the kind of responsibility which train the student to take responsibility. Why you have not completed coursework? while you have not done the assignment. So completing project, completing assignment is also a assessment tool, but rather it also develops the sense of responsibility. The students would develop their sense of responsibility by having such kind of assignments project. So assignment can also be classified in different way. That will be seen in the next slide. Assignment types: whole class assignment, small groups, workshops, independent work, peer learning, and contractual work. These are the kind of assignment types. Whole class, that means you would involve all the students in some kind of assignment you would give there, and you would ask them to finish one of time. Small groups, you make some kind of group of students and give the assignment and they would finish it. In small groups, a benefit is there. Some topics can be clarified by the student themselves. Means one student is not getting the topic properly by teacher. So he would discuss among themselves and one of them would make him understand the topic properly. It's also called peer learning, learning in the group. So it's also known as group discussion, you can see. So in a small group, peer learning, it is a considerable things we can apply here. Now next is workshops. If they perform various tasks simultaneously, workshops activities must be tailored to the lesson plan. At the basic level of school, workshop is not so applicable, but in the college level, workshop is very vital and important there. So we should consider workshop. In school level, we can do such kind of things by solving exhibition, science exhibition, art exhibition, such kind of things we can do. Independent work, student complete assignment, individually we have discussed later. Peer learning, same kind of small groups, they focus learning. And contractual work, teacher asks students, you need to complete the work within this time limit, then after allowing some kind of special things are required. So contractual work means teacher and student establish an agreement that the student must perform a certain amount of work by a deadline. So this is the all kind of assignment. Now sir, we need to proceed the next.